First of all, how has the week gone, do you feel? There were some questions that maybe a week was a bit too, not long enough to adjust to the time difference. How do you feel the team's feeling, certainly Gennady anyway?
Look, Gennady's such a professional, able. Yeah, they have this down to a science, and Gennady's had so many amateur fights, you know, internationally, that he's got great experience traveling. He doesn't care where he fights. He says it's the same ring, whether it's in the gym, whether it's in New York, Los Angeles, in the UK. He's just excited that the fight has come about with Cal Brook. I mean, the reaction that we've gotten ever since we announced the fight, it took really the boxing world by surprise. And now, how many weeks later, 6 weeks later, it's a fever pitch. You know, the ticket sold out in one day. As Eddie says, you know, 9, 10, 11 minutes, whatever it was. But, you know, it's certainly the fastest selling event that Gennady's been involved in. And you see the international reaction, not only from the fans, but the media covering the fight. And it's become the most talked about fight for 2016.
And Eddie said that he feels that Gennady's actually more nervous than Cal Brook at this point. What do you make of that?
Look, they're both undefeated world champions. Neither one of them knows how to lose. They're both great athletes, great representatives for the sport of boxing, great gentlemen outside the ring, great competitors inside the ring. So I don't think either one of them is nervous. Gennady's 35-0, Cal is 36-0. They've fought multiple times in world championship fights. But Cal went over to the U.S. and won the title in Los Angeles and brought it back to the U.K. It's very rare for a very marketable fighter from the U.S. Or that fights in the U.S. to come over and defend his titles in the challenger's home country. So we give Cal a lot of credit for moving up in weight. At the same time, you know, Gennady didn't insist that the fight had to happen in the U.S. where he normally fights. He was happy to come over here. You know, we've had always a big demand from the U.K. fans to see him live. You know, whether it was originally we were talking about Carl Froch, then we were talking about Billy Joe Saunders or Eubank, whoever it was. And Cal Brook is really the first one that's actually signed the contract. And now you see the reaction. I mean, Cal has tons of fans here in the UK. Gennady has a lot of fans. He fought Matthew Macklin. He fought Martin Murray. So he's very well known with the UK fans. And naturally being, you know, one of the most marketable fighters in the sport of boxing. And I think that's what that's what's really created so much interest in this fight.
How's Gennady been away from the cameras in the spotlight? And notice he hasn't done a huge amount of media, only bits and pieces during this week. Is that normal for him? Is that just something he likes to kind of wind down and stay away from it a bit?
Look, Gennady's a professional. He knows how to promote a fight. We had the kickoff press conference in New York. He flew from his training camp, flew to New York. Then 2 weeks later, we had the press conference in the UK. He broke his training camp, was on the plane. You know, you fly almost all day, then you get to the hotel, then we had the press conference, then flying back. And so he literally had 3 days from the middle of his training camp. A lot of fighters would never do that. So he knows how to promote a fight. It's fight week now. He knows that, I mean, he's 100% focused on the fight. If there's a misstep on Saturday night, everything that he's worked for, everything, all the plans that I have in the future are out the window if he doesn't win on Saturday night. So he's definitely focused. He's not nervous. It's just, he after traveling and being settled in, he just wants to, stay prepared for the fight on Saturday. And I think you'll see a tremendous performance from both guys.
Judging by the open workouts at Covent Garden, where the reception for him was brilliant, you know, there was no booing or anything like that, even though he's the away fighter, as it were. Will that be good for him at the O2? He's obviously boxed sold out at Madison Square Garden and the Forum in Los Angeles, but coming over here, he's not going into a hostile atmosphere, even though he is the away fighter.
You know, it's a strange phenomenon with Gennady. The first time I really saw it was when he fought Marco Antonio Rubio. That was in Los Angeles, California, and I would say about 80% of the fans were Hispanic or were from Mexico, and they were cheering for Gennady. I think it'll really be a 50-50 fight in terms of the fan reaction. Cal Brook, like I said, he's got a lot of fans, but the thing with Gennady is that the fans just appreciate his style. They appreciate his excitement in the ring, but they also appreciate his personality outside the ring. He's hard to root against. You know, they just appreciate his style. He always wants to put on a show for the fans. He doesn't, you know, he'll take punches in order to deliver punches. And he also, I mean, that's what Abel's instilled with him. He's like, this is the entertainment business. You have to entertain the fans. If they're going to buy a ticket to come see you fight, if they're going to turn on, you know, Sky Box Office to watch you fight, you've got to provide them entertainment. He doesn't want to do give someone a 12-round boring fight, then there's a controversial decision at the end. I mean, that's not good for the sport of boxing. And so a lot of times, I mean, he won't take unnecessary risks, but he'll certainly take risks in order to make the fight more exciting. And that's why he's become a fan favorite, regardless of which nationality, which demographic. It's just he's really elevated himself to the top of the sport of boxing. It's almost similar to a Mike Tyson effect when Mike was knocking everybody out. He became a legend in the sport. People just came to see his knockouts, and that's, I think, where Gennady is.